Hello everyone, in this edition, Ilia Malinin is expected to perform a triple axel at the stages of the Grand Prix. Rika Kihira has returned to competition. Camilla Valieva burst into tears when asked about the Olympics. Well, now about everything in order. Bright summer clothes for a bright holiday in this wonderful summer. The biggest discounts on the best design solutions. Spend a bright vacation this season with stylish clothes from the Fairy Season online store. Only by the link in the description, discount up to 60% for the Fairy Season sale. Follow the link in the description and get a big discount. Every day, thousands of fashionistas find the best look for themselves in which they will go to the evening, to the beach or to meet friends. 10,000 items of goods will allow you to find exactly your style and your design. For any mood, for any situation and for every type of holiday. Follow the link in the description and take what suits you. The International Skating Union has posted the distribution lists for the Grand Prix stages for the 22-23 season. Let us see what awaits the fans in the new season and what kind of figure skating ISU wants to offer us. The first thing that catches your eye is, of course, the absence of the main leaders of the last Olympic cycle in all sports. There are practically no names that make the ISU box office and attract most of the spectators to the stands. There are promising guys and those who are in the top, but at the same time, in the presence of leaders, they have never been a favorite of the competition. The world level of men's single skating still looks the most acceptable among all types, at least there is no obvious degradation yet. But even so, the lists of singles still look pretty faded. Expectedly missing are Olympic champions Yuzuru Hanyu and Nathan Chen, who warned fans in advance of their plans.
Hanyu announced his retirement, and Chen took a break to concentrate on his studies.
Yuzuru Hanyu and Nathan Chen personified men's single skating for many years. Young skaters looked up to them, their performances were watched by the whole world.
Hanyu could gather entire stadiums by his mere presence on the ice.
It is difficult to imagine further competitions without their participation.
Whatever one may say, the absence of two kings of men's single skating is a serious loss not only for ISU, but for the sport as a whole.
Many fans, especially Hanyu, will take time to let someone else into their hearts who they will be interested in following and who they will want to buy tickets for.
In addition to the absence of Nathan Chen and Yuzuru Hanyu, Jason Brown and Vincent Zhou are also missing from the list.
Brown, who delivered the short program to Daniel Grassel, probably also plans to completely miss the season or even end his sports career. Of the leaders of the US men's team, only the budding Ilia Malinin remained, from whom everyone in the new season will be waiting for the landing of the quadruple axel at the competition. The guy, of course, looks promising, his jumping technique is impressive, I want to believe that he will still write his name in history, but I must admit that today Ilia is a no-name figure skater for most figure skating fans. He has yet to prove himself in the international arena, win the love of the audience, prove his right to lead, and for this many factors must come together. The Japanese will have to save the male loner and maintain the level of spectator interest.
First of all, of course, this is the silver medalist of the Beijing Olympics Yuma Kageyama and the newly baked world champion Shoma Uno. Yuma has every chance to take the lead among men.
He is stable, he has a serious jump set, soft skating and, not least, he is very young, he is only 19 years old.
Shoma Uno, due to age, will be somewhat more difficult.
However, under the leadership of Stefan Lambiel, it continues to flourish and will certainly surprise us more than once.
Perhaps next season, the young Kamiura and Shun Sato will also be able to prove themselves.
They have a serious jump set, but they need more stability and self-confidence. It will also be interesting to look at Daniel Grassel, Matteo Rizzo, Kevin Amos, Dennis. The girls are pleased with the presence of Rika Kihira, who missed the entire last season, but it is difficult to say what level of skating the skater will be able to show at the Grand Prix stages. I was especially upset by the fact that, according to the skater, she still has not completely got rid of pain in her ankle.
So returning to the previous level is unlikely to be easy.
After a serious injury, the American Brady Tennell will also try to return to the ice. But her teammates Mariah Bell and Karen Chen for some reason were not announced for the stages, although Mariah planned to ride more in the absence of the Russians. The leader of the female single without Russian figure skaters, apparently, will continue to be Kaori Sakamoto. It is hard to imagine who will be able to impose a fight on her among the declared participants if the Japanese woman does not make gross mistakes. As for the ultra-sea elements, there is a feeling that the skaters will prefer not to take risks, choosing the better, simpler, cleaner tactics.
Unless a triple axel can be expected from Young Yu and Rika Kihira, but here a lot depends on the state of health.
Hypothetically, the triple axel can still be shown by Amber Glenn,
Wakaba Higuchi and Nana Kawabe. Isabo Levito will make her debut at the senior level and can seriously compete with other participants. At the junior starts, she looked very good and promising. The Russian school of figure skating was felt. Her coaches were Yevgeny Platov and Yulia Kuznetsova. The figure skater tried to study the quadruple sheepskin coat, but last year there was only one attempt at the local tournament. The jump turned out to be low. You can't expect miracles from other skaters. And if for men the bar clearly does not drop below the usual level, without 4 to 5 quadruple jumps in a free program it will be difficult to count on victory, then for women the picture will be completely different, and this is sad. In pairs, without Russians and Olympic champion Sui/Han, the situation is even worse than in women's singles. The 2022 world champions Alexa Nirim and Brandon Fraser, who have shown the best skates in their careers in France, are unlikely to be able to demonstrate stability at future starts.
There are still the Chinese couple Chang Pang and Yang Jin, the Japanese Riku Miura and Ryuichi.
But there is clearly no need to talk about some flowering of pair skating.
In dancing, it is worth recognizing, it is also not yet clear who could replace Gabriela Papadakis and Guillaume Sizeron.
Among the participants of the Grand Prix series, there is not a single dance duo who could even come close to the level of the French. Apparently, Madison Chalk and Evan Bates will take the lead in dancing, and Italians Charlene Gignard and Marco Fabri and Canadians Piper Gillis and Paul Poirier will try to impose a fight on them. They will most likely be assessed much better than before, so that the situation does not look too stalemate. The Canadian Figure Skating Federation refused to give the reason for the withdrawal of the request for the transfer of the Russian figure skater Natalia Zabiyako. In August, the first performance of Zabiyako in tandem with Zachary Daleman at a tournament in Canada was supposed to take place, but in July the Canadian Federation withdrew the request to transfer the Russian woman. It is not uncommon for athletes to ask permission to compete for different countries.
Given the confidential nature of any transfer request we may have received, we are unable to share any additional information, the organization said. Camilla Valieva burst into tears while answering a question about the Olympics. Russian figure skater Alexandra Stepanova was proposed after the ice show in Sochi. Her young man approached the skater and presented a bouquet of flowers. After that, he held out the wedding ring, kneeling. Stepanova is a 5-time winner of the European Championships in ice dancing. She performs in a duet with Ivan Bukin.